Hello everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on Cadence tool Virtuoso design environment. In this video I am going to tell you how to use this Virtuoso design environment for circuit design, and let us do the analysis for a simple inverter. First right click on the desktop and click on open in terminal. Then you need to type a Virtuoso space and symbol to invoke that. And here it will take you to the Virtuoso design environment. Here you can observe the Virtuoso framework license was checked out successfully. Then you can click on file. Here you need to create the library. You can go to new and then click on library. Then it will be asking for the library name which we are creating. Let me give it as test123. And you need to click on attach to an existing technology library and then click apply. And here it will be asking for the technology library. Here I am using GPDK90. This indicates a 90 nanometer technology I am using here. If it is the higher end technology, if it is available with you in your system, you can use that GPDK180 and all also. And click on apply and then OK. And then here again go to file, new, and I need to choose cell view. Now here I need to choose the library which I have created, that is test123. Within that I am creating a cell. Let me give the name of the cell as inverter and then click OK. This is the schematic I am creating, that's why I have choose schematic over there. So here you can observe, this is the window editor. I need to create my schematic. So basically an inverter will be consisting of a single P transistor and single N transistor. So here I need to put one N transistor and P transistor, and I need to make a connection. So GPDK90 is the technology I have chosen. I need to choose the transistors from that particular library. For that, you can see this icon here. This is create instance icon. Otherwise you can go to create here and you can click on instance. It will be asking for adding an instance into this editor window. Here I can browse for the library and GPDK90. Under that I am going to choose an NMOS transistor. Here after clicking on this NMOS, I need to choose the symbol for that. And here are the specifications it is asking for. Here if you want a customized transistor length, width and a finger width and all, you can choose this. And after giving these values, accordingly the transistor is going to be available for you. You can place it over here on the editor window. Since I need a space to put a P transistor here, I will put this N transistor little bit downwards, and you can click escape. And then I need to place one more transistor, that is P transistor, that is PMOS. So again go to add instance, then GPDK90, and I am going to search for PMOS. PMOS 1 volt is that, and then symbol. Here also again it will be asking for the specifications. If you want to set, you can set, and then you can place a transistor P here. Okay, again click on escape. Okay, this is what how the transistors are going to be placed. If you click on shift F, it will be fitted to the window. Okay, and then I need to make the connections to the drain, gate and source. As we know, drain and drain are the two transistors are connected, and we are going to take the output from those two. So I am going to connect a wire in between these two by choosing a narrow wire. And then gate and gate of the two transistors are always connected to give the input. That's why I am connecting gates again with the narrow wire. And I need to connect VDD to this point, and also I need to connect ground to this point. Before that, I need to make a connection from substrate to source. This is the source, here the arrow indicating the source, and by choosing the wire again I will be making the connection from source to substrate, and also here from source to substrate. Okay, this is what the source and substrate connection is. And then I need to place VDD and ground, and also input and output port. So click on create pin, and you can give the pin names as Vin space VDD space VSS space Vout. These are the four pins I need to put, but here it is asking for the direction. Since Vout is the output pin, I need to take it separately. So by clicking on that, you will be getting input pin, and then I have given VDD, I am going to place here. Then I have given VSS, I am going to place it here. Then again go to create pin and choose this Vout, give the name as Vout, or else you can give the name as you require, and click on output. The direction is output, and here I can place the output pin. This completes the pin placement. And now I need to connect with a narrow wire again from the source of P transistor to VDD, and then input pin to the gates, and output pin to the drain and drain, and VSS, or we can treat it as ground, from the source of this N transistor. So this completes the circuit of an inverter. This is a simple circuit of an inverter. So after after placing the transistors and the pins and all, we need to convert this schematic into a block diagram, or a block we can say. So for that, go to create, go to cell view, from cell view. So here it will be asking for the name. Let the name be same, no issues. Then apply, and it will be asking for the pins. Now this inverter what we have designed, this will be available with a block. So in that block, I need to keep the pins however we want. That's why the left pin will be always an input. That's why I am keeping V in as a left pin, and right pin is V out, and top pin is always VDD, and the bottom pin is VSS. I am keeping in this order. So if you click on apply and OK, you can observe here, this is what I am going to get for my inverter circuit. Now I can use this cell for an inverter. Wherever inverter is required, I can use this. So actually before coming to this, I need to check whether this circuit is correct or not. That's why click on save and check save. You need to click on check save, and if you come over here and check whether this circuit is correct or not, here it will be indicated that circuit's schematic check completed with no errors. If there is any errors in place of connection and all, it will be indicated. And test 1, 2, 3 inverter schematic is saved. After the confirmation, you can go to create, and then cell view, from cell view. Okay, and give the name, apply. It is already created, that's why it is asking for we need to replace or modify. I will click on replace. Again, it will be asking for the left, right, top and bottom pins. So I'm going to give the top pin, bottom pin and all, and then apply. It will be generated. Again, we need to check this block whether it is correct. So click on check and save. So this check and save is again confirming that that particular box or the cell which we have created is with no errors. Okay, after this confirmation, you can close all this, and again go to the Virtuoso window, again file, new, and then cell view. I need one more editor window to make a test bench. By giving the inputs and output pins, I need to check, I need to go with the analysis. That's why I am creating one more cell here. And by taking one more cell like this, now I need to place my inverter box here, inverter cell. That's why again it will be an instance. Go to create instance, browse, and the created cell will be within our library, that is test 1, 2, 3. Within that, inverter is the name given. So inverter, if you click on inverter, you can observe the symbol here, and then you can place it here in the editor window. Now you can observe it is named as inverter, and here we have Vin, VDD, Vout and VSS. So for this I need to give the input. Let me give the input as Vin pulse, pulse input. Again go to instance, browse. Within these libraries you can find analog library, analog lib. In that we'll be having voltage pulse, pulse input. So search for V pulse, otherwise you can give the name here itself if you know how actually it is given. If you give search for V pulse, it is available like this. So select this V pulse and a symbol. Here it will be asking for the specifications again. So let me give V2 voltage as 1.8 volts, period is 20 nanoseconds, 20 nano. And let me take delay time is 0, there is no delay. And rise time is, let me take it as 1 nanosecond. And also fall time is 1 nanosecond. And let me keep the pulse width is 10 nanoseconds. This is just the values I am taking for an instance to show you. And you can give the values as the design requires, okay. And then hide this. It will be a V pulse symbol. You can place it here near the V in. So I need to make connection from these two. Again, take a wire, connect from V in terminal to the V pulse, and I need to put a ground at the other end. Again, go to instance. You can close this. Go to instance, browse. Here only in the analog library, if you search for ground, it is available GND. Okay, click on that, take a symbol and place it here. Okay, and also for VSS I am not giving any negative voltage, that's why a ground is sufficient. And also one more ground is required here to place a VDD supply, the negative terminal. And also for the VDD I need to go with VDC, means the DC voltage I am going to give as a supply voltage from VDD. That's why here you can find VDC voltage, DC voltage with a symbol. And here I am going to give 1.8 volt for that also. 1.8 volt VDD I am providing here. That is what the meaning is. So I can place somewhere here and click on escape. Connecting this ground terminal near to that. And using a narrow wire again, I am going to connect these two. And I am connecting this supply to the VDD. Now this VDD connection with 1.8 volts. Okay. Similarly, I am giving a pulse input of 1.8. And I need to connect these two. And I need to make a ground connection with VSS. And Vout. Okay, for Vout, we need to connect a port. That is output representing V out, right? That's why it is V out. Okay. Again, I need to connect this V out port to the terminal. And if you want, you can place V in also for your reference by taking it as an input pin over here. Okay. So if you connect like this, you will not get confused where actually V in is if the circuit is bigger. Okay. This is how the VDC in place of VDD and Vin are going to be given for this particular cell view. Here also we need to save and then click on check save. Here again you can come back to this and check whether your cell is schematic is with no errors. Okay, here you can observe inverter TB is saved and with no errors. After this, you can analyze this circuit now with respect to transient and DC analysis. So for that, okay, go to launch. Here I am using ADEL. Click on ADEL. It will take you to the analysis options here. You can observe AC, DC, transient analysis. We can choose from this. Click on this. Here the first one is transient analysis. So for the transient analysis, I am going to give the stop time as 200 nano, up to 200 nanoseconds. I am taking the transient analysis, and let me choose this as a moderate with respect to the accuracy, and then apply. Okay, this gives us the transient analysis setup, and also I can give some I can also do DC analysis by choosing DC, and let me take the operating point. That's why you can click on the save DC operating point, and here you need to choose the component parameter, and by selecting the component parameter as the input pulse and by selecting the DC voltage, by selecting this, it is indicating that for the DC you are choosing the DC voltage as a pulse input varying from 0 to 1.8. That's why here it is 0 volts, the stop voltage is 1.8 volts. From 0 to 1.8 I am running. Okay, and then after this click on apply and then okay. So once the transient analysis setup is complete, here you can observe netlist run is there. Before clicking on netlist run, you need to choose the input and output ports, okay, for the analysis. So for that, go to outputs to be plotted, means I need to get a waveform, plotted waveform, so that I can analyze what is the transient and DC analysis output is. That's why go to outputs to be plotted and select on schematic. I can select the terminals from the schematic itself. So click on the input side connection or the wire, and also the output wire. Okay, this will take it as input port and the output port. In between those two, we are going to look at the waves. That's why here the outputs are selected as Vin and Vout, you can observe. Okay, and after doing this, you can click on run. You can click on this icon, otherwise you can go to simulation and you can run also. So click on netlist and run, or else you can click on here. It will generate a netlist. Here it is running the netlist 100% complete, and it is successful. And then after, it will be showing the waveform. So this is the waveform window. Here you can observe this first waveform or a plot indicating a transient response. Here it is mentioned as a transient response. Here we will be having two waves. One is Vin, other one is Vout. So it is difficult to analyze this since it is merged. Okay, that's why click on split currents strip. Okay, it will split it to the separate waves. So now this is Vin and this is Vout. You can observe here, as input increases, the increasing pulse, here we are going to get the decreasing pulse as a output Vout. Okay, this is Vin and this is Vout, exactly it is complementary to each other. The inverter output is correct. Now we can observe the DC analysis. Here is the DC analysis. Okay, here this red line indicating Vin, it is increasing from 0 to 1.8 volts. As it increases like this, how actually our output is decreasing from 1.8 to 0. Okay, and this is the operating point where the switching happens. Okay, so this is how you can do the transient response. You can take the transient response and also the DC response. In the similar way, you can design any circuit and you can analyze the transient as well as DC responses like this. And also you can come back to this circuit and you can make changes with respect to your requirement. If you increase VDD and also if you increase the pulse value, how actually you are going to get the DC and transient analysis, you can make by changing the values and again setting the DC as well as transient analysis here.